What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel and thank you for tuning in. Today I'm going to give you guys a 30,000 mile review on the MotoFab 2.5-inch leveling kit, 2-inch lift blocks, and upper control arms for your 2014 to 2019 Chevy or GMC half-ton pickup trucks. Alright guys, so for those of you who aren't aware and who aren't up to date here, this is my 2018 Chevy Silverado 1500 half ton. It's a 5.3, four-wheel drive, nothing special here. When I bought this truck, I wanted to fit a bigger wheel and tire, as most people like to do. But the problem with GM vehicles with the square wheel wells is you really can't fit much bigger of a tire than what comes on these things factory. So this truck like runs a 265. You might be able to squeeze like a 285 on here without rubbing. 295. Maybe. So the ultimate goal is to fit like a 33, which is what we ultimately did. And I don't like the half ton trucks lifted. I don't like light duty trucks lifted. I just don't like the look of it. So the alternative was to do a leveling kit. And so that's exactly what we did. We bought a 2.5-inch MotoFab leveling kit and put it on the front of the truck. And you'll be able to see it right here. That's the spacer right there that goes on top of the strut. And that was a 2.5-inch, like I said, MotoFab leveling kit. Went with 2.5 because if I would have gone 1.5 inches, 2 inches, I felt like I wasn't getting the best bang for my buck. 3 inches seems to be where people start having issues with these trucks, popping out ball joints and just having bad CV angles and whatnot. So we went with 2.5 inches just as a happy medium. And then as an added bonus, the ass end of this truck sat 2.5 inches higher than the front. So I figured it would give the truck 100% perfect level look. So if you want to see the install of the leveling kit, I will link it up here in the corner of the screen. Check that guy out. You'll see the full install. The level itself cost like 90 bucks. The installation was zero because I did it in my driveway in like a couple hours. And then the only thing I had to do is get a front end alignment just to make sure everything was nice and tight and aligned up front. So realistically, a pretty cheap setup. And we went with MotoFab just because it seemed to be the best brand for these trucks. Now, tons of companies make them, like Rough Country and whatever else kind of stuff that you got. But MotoFab is based here in the US, which is nice, and I couldn't find any flaws in their product. So that's why we went with MotoFab in general. So we leveled the truck. It looked really good, and it was 100% level, which was my problem, because anytime I hooked up to a trailer or loaded the bed with my quad, a load of gravel, whatever, it would squat the truck, and I don't like the look of squatted trucks. So what we ended up doing, we ended up going back to MotoFab and getting a 2-inch lift block kit for the rear. We went with a 2-inch lift block kit, which you can see right there. There's the blocks with my camera focuses. And once again, no issues to date. Now, I forgot to mention, when I bought this truck at 0 miles, I put the leveling kit on at 1,000 miles, and I currently have like 36,000. So I'm actually over 30,000 miles on the front leveling kit, and I'm happy to report I've had zero issues, not a single issue with that kit. No creaks, no pops, no nothing. I'm very happy with it. And then so when we went with the block kit, I probably had about 5,000 miles on the truck. So I got a good 30,000 miles on the blocks, and it came with bigger U-bolts and whatnot to adjust for it. And what that block kit did was it gave me my factory rake back. So my truck now sits another 2 inches higher in the rear, which is nice because when I hook up to a trailer or load the bed with stuff, it then levels the truck out. So it don't look like no yee-yee truck all the time. People hate on me all the time because I like the factory rake of trucks, but in my opinion, it makes it look aggressive. It gives it a really nice stance, and I just like it. So the block kit in the rear was the same type deal. It was like 90 bucks. I did the installation in my driveway at home. I'll link that video up in the top corner as well. You could check that out, and you needed literally nothing else to accommodate for that. So 2.5-inch MotoFab leveling kit up front, a good 35,000 miles on them, realistically, no issues. And then the 2-inch lift block kit in the rear, a good 30,000 miles on that, and once again, no issues. And then the latest and last mod that I want to talk about is the MotoFab upper control arms, MotoFab aftermarket upper control arms, which you'll be able to see right there. There's the MF logo. And I actually didn't even purchase these. I didn't I didn't need them. I don't think I needed them. Now, I hear if you do get to 3-inch level, these would be kind of necessary just to kind of help correct your ball joint angle and whatnot, but this is a 2.5-inch. I was in good shape. I probably ran this entire setup before the upper control arms for a good 20,000-25,000. And then I was lucky enough to have MotoFab reach out to me and ask me if I wanted to try out a set of their new upper control arms that they made for these guys. And so obviously I said yes. Put these on probably somewhere around 25,000-26,000 miles, I believe. And what that did do, it did correct a lot of the ball joint angle. It also came with a greasable Moog ball joint, which the factory upper control arms do not have. So there's the ball joint itself. And it did kind of correct the CV angles and whatnot. That's exactly what this kit was designed to do, is to correct the angles and whatnot. And it definitely did that. So I'm not sure if this is a necessary mod, but I will tell you, it feels a lot better driving with the MotoFab upper control arms versus the OEM ones. Just gives you a safer feeling driving down the road. Now, I'll be honest, when we drove this thing down to Daytona for Daytona Truck Meet, we're doing 2,000 miles of highway. I was kind of scared because we didn't have the MotoFab upper control arms at that point. I was afraid this truck on a 2.5-inch level on the bigger 33s and offset wheels and tires, I was afraid that it was going to, I don't know, pop a ball joint going down the road or a tie rod end or something. These Chevys are known when they get lifted with big tires and stuff to do the ka-chow mod, and I wasn't cool with that at all. So we got these from MotoFab after Daytona, but it's been fine ever since. We just took a trip down to Tennessee, and I've driven this thing literally everywhere since putting these on, and you don't have that feeling of like, oh my God, if I hit a pothole, I'm gonna die. It does give you a lot more comfort driving with these guys on the highways and whatnot, so I definitely don't worry as much with the upper control arm. So they've been pretty good ever since as well. And that's legit all I have for you guys. Like I said, short, simple, and sweet. Just wanted to give you guys a good review on the MotoFab leveling kit, upper control arms, and lift block kit before I took it all off and got rid of the truck. Nothing fancy in this video. Just wanted to go over that stuff and tell you that I'm very impressed with it. I liked it a lot. So if you're considering it, I got 35,000 miles on the truck. I've had no issues whatsoever. So very happy with it. Good job, MotoFab. You guys are awesome. That's about it, guys. Legit. So like the video if you haven't already. Subscribe. Join the family. Join the build. Thank you, guys. Peace.